Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Wulansari Khairunisa. I came from Indonesia, and I'm a part of Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team in Indonesia. I'm so happy to have this opportunity to speak in here, and this is also my first time joining State of the Map Global. Here, I would like to share about my experience on Indonesia road mapping project, where the topic is still related to the topic that Dristi has just brought, using their tools, artificial intelligence, to improve the roads in Indonesia. So since 2011, HOT in Indonesia began the efforts to create a best map to disaster preparedness using OpenStreetMap. And since then, the OpenStreetMap community in Indonesia has continued to grow and expand their expertise in using application like NSF. They can calculate the hazard impact, and they also and it needs like the exposure data like building and roads. However, this map is still lack a lot of road networks, and that we need more road networks data that outside the big cities or outside the major cities. And therefore, the acceleration efforts were needed to increase the road coverage. As mentioned by Dristi before, after Thailand mapping, they are continuing to Indonesia. So here we are now working together with Facebook team, also with the local people in Indonesia to improve road coverage in Indonesia, and we're also using their tools to quickly identify more roads. And the team is made up of the member of the local community in Indonesia in order to ensure the effort is locally led, and also in coordination with the local knowledge and the tagging standards. And this is our timeline since we began the project. So we start from 2017. At the beginning of November, we held the team recruitment to get the team that consists of like 4 quality assurance and 20 data entries. And after that, we gave them the training for OpenStreetMap, although most of them are already familiar with the OpenStreetMap because they've joined the HOT's previous project. And after that, like just Dristi mentioned in their presentation, we did the road data cleaning to fix some of the most warning that we found. Like oversimplified road, antiquities, missing bridges, and road crossing buildings. And in February 2018, Facebook team came to Indonesia and give us the training about how to use their tools, which is the tools is still the same with OpenStreetMap tools like ID Editor and also Task Manager, but the customized one. And start from March, we're working on training project on the Tasking Manager to get familiar with the whole mapping process for the human editing, such as editing, reviewing, publishing, and post-submission validation. And start from May, we start working with a real tasking project where the result that we've edited and validated will be uploaded into live OSM data. We also put some ground truth activity in our timeline, and this agenda actually is still quite flexible, depends on the need. So since we start the real project for almost 3 months, this is our current progress. There are 1,900,000 submitted nodes, 65,000 submitted ways with total length almost 29,000 kilometers. and it covered 6 of the 34 provinces in Indonesia, which is located in Sulawesi Island. And here's a visualization of road density map showing the changes in Indonesia start from the April the 1st this year. This is the other screenshot overlay road data coverage in OpenStreetMap. The red one is the blue one is from April the 1st, and the red one is in this month. From here, we can see how many new roads have been added, and we're not only adding the major road, but also the road that in the lower classes that can be identified from the satellite imagery, like tracks. And as you can see, there are a lot of roads branches here. We also try to compare road data owned by our national mapping agency in Indonesia, that we usually call BIG. This green one is from the National Mapping Agency, and this is from OpenStreetMap. We can see that the OpenStreetMap data is more dense than the National Mapping Agency have. And so in this case, OSM data is kind of play a role complement in completing the missing roads in our National Mapping Agency data. So how did this happen? Maybe because it can because BIG mapping with the coverage for whole Indonesia with the scale of 1 to 50,000, which OSM has smaller and more details scale, and it also depends on the version or the last update from their data. So in this data, its last update is 2013. They will update every 5 years, which is this years. But it takes so long for them to update the data because of their limited human resource to do that for the with the large countrywide. And during this project, we face some of the challenges, and this is the most challenges that we face. First is determining road classification. So it's not easy for Indonesia team to determine the road classification. That's why we try to find like official reference and hoping it will make us easier to determine the road classification. And in Indonesia, there are at least 3 national institutions that have authority or task to provide the data or the road classification. That is Ministry of Public Work, National Mapping Agency, Ministry of Transportation. But what we found is the differences in road classification standard from those 3 institutions. And which is actually made us confused. Besides that, these 3 institutions also have different naming standard. The Ministry of Public Work determine road classification based on authority and or responsibility for the road, such as the provincial roads, national roads, and district roads, sub-district roads, and so on. While the National Mapping Agency determine road classification from the function of the road, such as the artery road and collector roads and local roads. While Ministry of Transportation determine the classification based on the traffic and road transportation needs. And it's not easy for us to adapt and customize those classification into a standard classification that available in OpenStreetMap. The other reason is because Indonesia as maritime country which has different road characteristic in each island. For example, primary roads on Java Island may be different with this Sulawesi Island. in terms of size, specification, and also quality. It is also influenced by the difference of development condition in Indonesia, where development in Western Indonesia is faster than in Eastern region of Indonesia. And besides that, every island in Indonesia has different geographical characteristics that affect the development planning. The other challenge is the quality of the satellite imagery. Quality of the satellite imagery it's quite we have something like road coverage. So Facebook machine learning use the imagery from the Digital Globe Premium to trace the road because it is considered to be the most vivid imagery that available compared to the other provider of the open imagery. But the reality is when we do the mapping, we still find many conditions like this. It cannot be denied that the high cloud coverage in Indonesia it's because the location of the Indonesia that located in the equator and or the tropical zone, where the rate of the evaporation is very high. And besides that, the majority area in Indonesia is like a rural area, where in the rural area demand for good quality is still low. And so it's like there's no urgency for the provider to provide the cloud-free imagery for that area. They will give priority to the big cities. And we made some several efforts to facing those challenges, where when we do the efforts, we also found and it opens up the good opportunities to us. First is we got more contribution or collaboration from the local people through training and discussion. So 3 weeks ago, we held the 3 days OpenStreetMap training to two local universities in South Sulawesi. And in this training, we also held a discussion session about the road network in South Sulawesi. This activity is held just before we did the ground truth. And one of the university had the participant that came from the civil engineering students, where they get course on the design of the road and bridges. And after this discussion, we got a lot of enlightenment about the condition and the classification road in South Sulawesi. And we got more contribution through ground truthing. This first ground truthing were located in South Sulawesi, and this activity involves the students from those two university. We also interact with some local people to get to know about their local knowledge. And the ground truth, we were needed to validate the object that we think it's ambiguous or it's difficult to identify only from the satellite imagery, such as small bridges, disconnected road because of seasonal floods or waterway, and building above the street. The example for small bridges, so we sometimes not sure how to map it, to give the information to this object, whether this is the bridge that can be passed by the vehicle like a car or only for a motorcycle or only can be passed by the pedestrian, because this condition is also related in determining the road classification of the connected road here. And the other difficult things that we need to make sure it's disconnected roads because of seasonal river. In this first sample, we can see that there's a clearly road, and it seems like the main road. And the question is, it is really disconnected or like cut off by the river? And if it's so, where is the main road then? Through the ground truthing, we found that the road was indeed cut off, but the local people using the boat as a transportation to cross the river. So basically, this road is usually used for their daily activity. And the second example is, we can see clearly visible road over the seasonal water. And this road became road that people use daily activities too. But in this case, the river actually can be crossed. So we usually add some more tag like fort, yes, to mark this road is still can be passed. And building above the street. So in Indonesia, there are many buildings that seems to like closing the road. But the reality is, the building is situated above the road, and where it formed like a corridor where the vehicle or people still can pass by under the building. And the object is often found in the residential where there are a large like a mosque and schools. In Indonesia, also a very common found object that like this. That apparently it is like a top of the roof for the village gates, and this is often found in the like the end of the road or the entrance of the village. The other opportunities is the increase the use of OpenStreetMap data in various fields. So a lecturer from one of the universities that we've trained expressed his interest in including OpenStreetMap material into their study curriculum, and which is very good to increase the use of OpenStreetMap. They asked our support, from HOT team, to like give them assistance in the initial stage. So this is in the university that the student have the like a course with this civil engineering. So the other opportunity is OSM can be the solution for this problem in Indonesia. First is low awareness to spatial data. So Indonesia is one of the country with which has low availability and accessibility to spatial data. That cause people have low awareness to how important it is. And most people in Indonesia think that map is Google. So if we don't have Google, we cannot access the map easily. And the second is spatial data is not up to date. So like our data from the National Mapping Agency, sometimes it's not up to date. Because National Mapping Agency, it's like don't have branches or local office, and just like I said before about the limited of human resource. And the last thing is spatial data is not free, required high cost. If there's any up to date data, it belongs to private sector, which is. Where the data is not open, and it requires a high cost to get it. Okay, so here are the face of our team. There are 24 staff in total for quality assurance, 20 data entries, and me as a mapping supervisor. I think that's all from me, and thank you. Please feel free if you have any questions.
So, question time. Any question? Okay.
Hi. Same in the Philippines, there are more OSM data on roads. compared to our national mapping agencies. Do the national mapping agencies use OSM or are considering using it?
Actually, national mapping agencies really appreciate with the OpenStreetMap, but they don't use our OpenStreetMap data for their official capacity because they have their own mandate or job to do that. And yeah, I mean, that's all.
Okay. We have time for another one. Okay.
Hello. Just very good presentation, first of all. And second, are you able to also say if the bridge, for example, is of quality or not? If the weight that it can support, are you able to go at that precision, level of precision? Because I've seen in Africa bridges which are actually not passable, which are too dangerous to be used. So are you able to give that information as well?
Yeah, that's why we do the ground truth for that kind of object, because we need to know about the condition. But basically, in Indonesia, every bridge that looks like a small bridge, even it's long or just or short, it's only accessible by the pedestrian. And I mean, from our information that we got from the field survey, it can be applied in another location.
Okay, so thank you.
Thank you.